Good evening and welcome to Arizona Horizon. I'm Ted Simons. The Phoenix City Council recently voted to give City Manager David Cavazos a $78,000 a year raise. That's a salary increase of 33%, and it's led to quite a bit of controversy. Among those none too pleased with the pay increase is Laurie Roberts, a columnist for the Arizona Republic. Good to see you again. Thanks for joining us.
Good to see you. Glad to be here.
Okay, let's get some facts out here first. It was a 33% raise. Takes him to what?
His raise will take him to $315,000 a year in base pay. But don't forget that he also, as one of the executives in the city, has a deferred pay program, which is based on a percentage of his base pay. So it will also mean an additional $8,600, maybe give or take $50 in there, but about $8,600 more in deferred pay. So it is...
Yes.
It is really more like a raise of, my math is not that good, journalist here, about $86,000 total. That's the amount of the increase.
Yes, and this doesn't include, we have a car allowance in here as well?
He gets $600 a month in a car allowance, which is about $7,200 a year. He gets a yearly longevity bonus.
What does that mean, a longevity bonus?
That's what they say, that when you're at the top of your pay scale and they can't give you any more, although I didn't know that a city manager evidently is never at the top of his pay scale, but for other employees, for mere staffers, when you get to the top of your pay raise, they will give them a once-a-year bonus, what they call a longevity bonus, to keep you.
I see.
So that you don't, once you've topped out. So he gets a $4,000 longevity bonus, the $7,200 car allowance, and now with this raise, it will be about a deferred pay plan of about $35,000 a year.
Okay. Why do you think this pay raise is wrong?
Well, I think it's wrong on a couple levels. Number one, a couple of years ago, the city employee groups were all asked to take pay and benefit cuts totaling 3.2%, I believe, and they went along with that to help out the city because they had budget problems. Things got a little better, about half of that was increased, but they still haven't gotten the rest of that back. It just seems wrong to me that you're giving raises of this magnitude when you have not yet restored fully the pay and benefits of your employees, the people that you and I see out on the street, the guy that picks up the garbage, the person who fills the potholes, the police officer that comes when I call 911. Let's make those people whole first. And secondly, the city of Phoenix, if you remember, told the city's citizens that they were going to pay a 2% food tax. Until you get rid of that food tax, you have no business, none, giving a raise of this magnitude.
Okay. The city says that Mr. Cavazos, his reforms already have saved the city about $59 million.
That is apparently true, and I say good for him. That was his job. Good for you. You did it, and you did it well.
And the same thing with now your editorial board. The paper came out with an editorial saying that Cavazos earned this increase because he led the city from a multi-million dollar deficit to a surplus, and that he met performance goals, and that's how you deal with these things.
Well, I might add that I don't think he led them alone. I think that there were a few rank-and-file employees right there with him doing what they could. And again, I have no criticism of Mr. Cavazos, the way that he does his job. My problem is with the scope and the scale and the sheer magnitude of this raise. Keep in mind, the median household income in the city of Phoenix is just under $44,000 a year. His raise, the increase that he got, is twice that. It's just unbelievable.
So for those like the city, like the Republic editorial board, who say that you have to do this, you have to pay these people commensurate with what they could maybe find on the open market, or at least pay them what they're worth in order to keep good people,
then I say let him go test that open market. See how many jobs out there offer this sort of pay and benefits. And remember, we didn't even talk about this, but along with this pay increase, that will boost his lifetime pension by a great deal. Tell me another place other than CEO of a major corporation where you're going to get that kind of money. If he needs to test the market, he should test it. And I would certainly say that in better times, when there's no food tax, when you're not taxing people for their groceries, when the employees have been made whole, then there's a time to say, are we paying a competitive rate to keep this guy? Certainly, I think that we should pay a competitive rate. But we're going to be paying more than, to my knowledge, any other city with this form of government, a council city manager form of government, other than San Antonio.
So do you see this both as the wrong move at the wrong time, A, and B, maybe a little bit of tone deafness going on here?
Complete lack of tone deafness. The other one of the things that they told me, I mean, I even underestimated these people, and that's hard for me to do. Last week, Sal DeCicio, when I talked to him about why even he was going for this, I asked, when did this pay raise take effect? And he goes, oh, it takes effect in July. I assumed they meant the coming fiscal year, July 1. No, they made it retroactive to July of 2012.
Interesting. I was not aware of that. Another argument is, yes, he could go test the open market, but if he were to leave, the cost of replacing him, considering what this position pays, might be more expensive than just going ahead and paying them retroactively nonetheless, paying them now, getting the increase out there
now. You know, there's right and there's wrong, and I'm really surprised that Mr. Cavazos is this tone deaf, that he doesn't see. Go out to West Phoenix and see how people are living. Go down to South Phoenix and see how your residents are living. It's just a time and a place thing, and a 33% raise is just outrageous. If he is below market, let's bring him up in an appropriate fashion. I don't know that you have to be the number two highest paid city of our size cities with the kind of government we have. But sure, I don't begrudge the man making more money. But you can't tell me that you're going to be giving 33% raises to the rank and file this year. And you can't tell me that they're not doing a good job.
So in other words, should the city handle this in a different stair-step, the increase, gradually bring it in? Are you saying 33%, though? Is 33% too much?
I think it's 33% too much right now when you have people paying that food tax. I would say whatever raises are anticipated for city employees this year, you should get the same. The city of Peoria, I think it's Peoria, just raised their city manager's pay. They raised it 2.5%. Mm-hmm.
City of Mesa, though.
Who's getting big 10% raises anymore?
Well, and no kidding. Not me. The city of Mesa apparently is looking at increasing the mayor's salary from $38,000 to $70,000. That's a healthy increase, although some would argue that $70,000 for the mayor of a city the size of Mesa is still not all that competitive. And the council's going from $19,000 to $35,000. So in terms of percentages, there's a lot of government workers getting some increases out there.
You know, I really want to get a job where I can vote to raise my own pay. That's my dream job, because I think I'm worth a whole lot more than I'm paid now. The city of Mesa got this idea that since nobody ran for the Mesa City Council, clearly this is a job that nobody wants, therefore we better raise our own pay. The legislature would do the same thing if they could. They're just precluded from doing it by state law.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I would agree that for a part-time city council position, maybe they should be paid more. I'm not convinced. Maybe the mayor. But these are all strong city manager forms of government. I don't know what Greg Stanton makes in the city. I shudder to think. But I don't know that I would say it would be much more than 70 or 80.
Yeah, not in the $300,000 range that we're talking about now. And again, correct me if I'm wrong, this was the same gentleman that was disciplined at one time for travel expense curiosities, correct?
Cavazos? He was. He was disciplined because he was overseeing a manager in a department where they just had all kinds of crazy things going on with people, you know, taking management trips, safaris, and other sorts of trips as part of the aviation department. He was one of several who were suspended for 5 days, and like 3 months later, he was promoted to deputy city manager. So go figure.
So the last question here. Are you surprised, and don't go too far with your editorial board there at your own paper, but we can talk about that if you want to refer to it. But the paper, a guy like Sal DeCicio, who's supposed to be such a fiscal hawk, that city council seems enthralled with Mr. Cavazos. Are you surprised that so many folks think this is a swell idea?
I don't think that many folks think it's a swell idea. I think that the newspaper's editorial board obviously thinks it's a swell idea. I think that Sal DeCicio and seven other members of the city council think it's a swell idea. But the people that I'm hearing from, who are the people that live and shop and work for the city and in the city, they don't think it's a swell idea at all. They think it's outrageous, and I agree.
Well, all right. It's good to have you. Good to see you again. Thanks for joining us.
You too. Merry Christmas.